Rungrad Sasi Prapa making his way to the ring, 80 fight on his record. Really has been tipped as one of Thailand's next generation of superstars. But I'll tell you what, Rungrad Sasi Prapa, fresh from a victory over in Ireland. But, you know, Greg Wooten, I've had the pleasure of him come down to my gym, and he comes down for sparring. Very, very strong, big light welterweight, very tall, excellent in the knees, great with his elbows. It's going to be a real good fight between two very tall light welterweights.
We mentioned just now an impressive win streak it was for Panagos Youssef, and Greg Wooten is one man who has defeated him. That tells you something about his quality, and here he is to a rapturous ovation.
Yeah, you know what, he's a very, very humble guy, quietly confident, and he trains very, very hard. This is his life, and he wants to fight the best Thais in the world. Rungrad Sasi Prapa, a young fella himself, got a very impressive record, and you know, I'm looking forward to it.
Now, Greg Wooten, recently interviewed on London Live Television. He's training in preparation for this competition. Fought kickboxing rules. He's the current Infusion World Champion. Beaten numerous international opponents. He's claimed arguably the biggest scalp ever achieved by a Westerner, November 2014.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a light welterweight contest to be fought over 5 3-minute rounds between, and introducing to you, firstly, fighting out of the blue corner, coming to you by way of Thailand, Rungrad Sasi Prapa. And standing across the ring, his opponent. He comes to you by way of the KO gym in London, Greg the Prodigy Wooten. 5 3-minute rounds.
And met with some applause as well. So one of the big and anticipated fights of the evening. Lots of build-up, lots of talk on social media and on news channels for this one as well. Greg Wooten in the KO gym in London in the red corner. Rungrad Sasi Prapa all the way from the shores of Thailand in the blue corner. 5 3-minute rounds, full Thai rules. Here we go.
And like I said about Greg, he's high energy. He'll switch from orthodox to southpaw, throw kicks. He'll try and confuse his opponent. Rungrad said a young man, but very, very well versed and a powerful kicker.
Seconds out, round one.
Yeah, no touching gloves, I tell you. Greg's there to mean business. Oh, no mucking around with these two.
Wow.
What you'll find out with Rungrad, he threw a couple of elbows early to try and scare his opponent. You know, it can put people off, and sometimes you don't want to get involved, but Greg's not that type of person.
Great strike to the midsection from Greg Wooten.
Nice. Good footwork there. Rungrad's the slower of the two, you can tell already. But he'll keep stalking, but how much can he take?
And Wooten's done well just to spin his man in there. Just digs a knee into the midsection, then another. Third there. And how does height favour the clinch? Is it easier if you're a taller man?
Well, you know, it depends. You know, if you're short, sometimes you'll get underneath the arms and drive the knees in the ribs. If you're taller, you want to pull the head down, having a wide base. Excellent movement there from Greg. I don't know if you're seeing it. He's actually orthodox fighter, but he does fight from a southpaw position, and he moves. He's just chopping that leg the whole time. Oh, lovely little elbow there. I don't think that Mongrat seems a little bit surprised by the pace there. Just walking in, he's getting caught every time. Nice shot. See that left low kick again we talked about. I'm telling you, he's going to keep going for that.
He's drawing the attention with the hands. Pulling the kick in low.
And Mongrat is tired.
It's fantastic handwork from Greg Wooten. He's absolutely, he's punching straight through the guard, in fact.
Chris, I tell you, he would do this all night. I've seen him in the gym. We do 12, 15 rounds, and he does 12, 15 rounds straight this pace.
Is that typical of the Thailand pace?
No, it's not.
Slower than the English
usually pace? Slow, but Greg, like I said, he's got his own style, and he's speeded up, and he's certainly, you know, he's having his way with Rungrat at the moment. And like you said, Chris, Greg doesn't look like a fighter at all, but you can just see there from the first couple of minutes, he is. left elbow.
Lovely elbow. Sasa Prabha's taking all sorts of punishment to the head on the ropes. And struggling to give himself any room to work at all.
It's just, I told you, just high energy, high work rate, the will to win.
Just driving those knees in, using the size and the strength in the corner. Sasa Prabha looking really out of gas already. Eating jabs, lovely uppercut as well.
It's killing his head.
And again, that low kick sweeps him away. And if the ropes are up there, fantastic work from Greg Wooten. Well,
great round from Greg. You know, everything, the whole arsenal, the knees, elbows, hard low kicks. He hurt Mongrat with that back leg low kick. And Mongrat literally looked like a rabbit in headlights there, didn't he?
Just didn't have any answer to the questions that Greg Wooten was posing. Like you say, the face of a nice guy, but the moves of a bad guy.
And you can just see here now that Mongrat tried to mix fire with fire, but just coming unstuck. He's getting caught. And like I said, Greg throws things from all angles, but he's got great footwork. And I'll tell you what, he's a clever young man as well. He studies the game well.
Fabulous combinations he was throwing. Three shots unanswered, then the low kick. And we saw that on numerous occasions. As soon as Sasa Prabha tried to step in, Wooten just throwing that 1-2-3 combination, then the left kick. Some low.
You know what? I think if Greg keeps his pace up after three rounds, I can't see Rungrat taking this. Just a man on a mission that first
absolutely
round.
Absolutely.
You know, I'm going to tell you now that never write ties off, because sometimes they just take, you know, they're so conditioned. This is their sport, of course, don't forget. And although he got caught with everything there, don't be surprised if he comes out strong round two and three.
Corners, 10 seconds.
Well, there's one thing tonight, it's certainly taught us it's never write anybody off at any stage.
No, certainly not. As you've seen, you know, from earlier bouts.
But so far, so good.
Seconds out.
For the Londoner.
Round two.
And again, Wooten in control, just spins his man onto the ropes in the clinch. Oh, nice knee to the inside of the leg though, from Sasa Prabha.
And you might find this with Rungrat. What he might try and do is just tie up Greg, trying to hopefully to tire him. Oh,
yeah, lovely elbow. That,
you know, from southpaw, he throws a straight left and steps through with a right elbow.
Yeah, a couple of people shouting from the crowd, he doesn't want any more.
Wow,
more Wooten lands it. Sasa Prabha is having to really, really dig deep.
Fair play to Sasa Prabha's chin now, and he's still coming forward. He's just getting caught every time.
And Wooten, nice straight high kick to the head there. He's thrown him down, knee to the head.
Yeah, it's perfectly legal, all in the motion.
And he's caught him now, looks for the sweep. Doesn't quite get it. Again, he's just so dominant in these exchanges.
Yeah, Wow, I tell you, his footwork, if you're watching his feet here, ladies and gentlemen, you can see the South Porter Orthodox dance, straight one, twos down the middle. Very bread and butter, but they're working. I tell you what, the condition of Sassy Prapper, whether he can take this.
Credit where it's due, he's done well to take what he's taken.
Yeah, he has.
Thus far.
That's what I'm saying, it's incredible that he can take so much. Big knees under the ribs as well.
He's worried, looks from his corner. Trying to fight so hard just to stay in this, and Wooten just will not relent with this pace.
Nice turn as well, just showing his balance.
And again, a nice combination. And Wooten showing great hands, great feet.
I tell you what, it'd be horrible to fight because he just literally from he's throwing kicks from close, he's throwing boxing from Orthodox to Southpaw.
And again, now from the Southpaw starts, lead, right jab, the backhand's off the end of it, and Sassy Prapper has just got no defence against them either. As soon as he steps in, punches are going straight through the guard, in the clinches, he's getting the better of the knee exchanges, he's stronger, seems to be able to spin him whenever he wants to. He's completely outworking him in terms of volume and pressure.
Good round there again for Greg. Two rounds of this relentless pressure. You can see Rungrat limping back to the corner there, and his corner have got to do a job on him there.
Well, what on earth do you say if you're Rungrat Sassy Prapper's corner man there?
No, he's just slouched back to the corner. You know, like I said, never write him off. But Rungrat wants space. He wants space. He wants to try and load those kicks off, try and set the pace up. Greg's not the type of person to let you dictate a pace. He's the one that will be in front of you the whole time. He's just there again, that low kick.
Right to the back of the leg. And then the combinations off the back of it. Fabulous.
Great combination.
1-2 uppercut, then the leg. Driven in and kicked to the chest.
And like I said about Greg, he's a right-handed southpaw as well.
So that jab comes in with real force when he does switch it.
Absolutely, and he'll throw a cheeky uppercut right through the middle.
Bottom of the foot connecting with the chin there. Just everything following up, not giving his opponent any space at all.
You see that, a knee to a punch, and then with another left hand. You know, and fair play to his coaches at KO Gym. You know, Bill Judd was his original coach at KO Gym. He stepped aside now. Richmond Anand's now come in. And David Paquette as well, part of the team, have done a great job on him.
Seconds out.
Sassy Brown's corner really working hard on him, physically and mentally.
You know, can he withstand pressure like that for another round? But you never write any fighter off at this level.
Forward he comes now. He's going to really try and put Greg Wooten to the test. But instantly, the same pattern. Oh, straight right hand from Wooten. And then the high kick.
The balance there as well.
Sassy Prapper's caught it, but again, just hasn't got the power to sweep the planted foot off the floor.
I don't know so much so what Rungrat's game plan is. I think he's just trying to tie up Greg and score some big knees. Personally, if I was him, I'd try and get it on the outside and try and throw some big kicks in, because every time he comes in close, he's getting caught.
And Wooten just snuck in the elbow a couple of occasions there, the left elbow, and now the knees. As you say, if he's used to working at this pace, then for Greg Wooten, this is just a... almost routine for him.
Exactly that.
Whereas for Sassy Prapper, you get the distinct impression from his face and his body language that he's well out of his comfort zone in this sort of exchange. And one thing you need when you are out of your comfort zone is a bit of space and a bit of time to assess what's in front of you and try and make another decision, and he's just not been given that at any stage of the contest.
No, not at all. And I said, usually in Thailand, round one and two is a slow pace. Round three, they pick the game up. Round four, of course, it's full speed. But
oh, lovely kick, switch it.
Beautiful.
Fantastic. Just switch from south.
Oh, and again. If he's going to finish him, Chris, I'm sure. Rungrat's chin is made of iron.
Absolutely amazing.
He took a big kick. Twice.
Went from southpaw to orthodox. Threw the high kick in. And banged in possibly two more. As you say, that is real testament to the conditioning of the Thailand man, because he has taken some pasting in there.
Oh, it's going to go, I'm sure.
From Wooten. Unbelievable.
Big elbow.
Comes in with the elbow. The referee having a look.
Brutal, isn't it?
It's mate. I'm amazed that there's not been any blood drawn at this stage.
Thai seems to have this elephant skin, I tell you. I've whacked him a few times with elbows, and I've just seemed to be touched and I get cut.
Sasaprapa, bizarrely, you know, the amount of punishment he's taken, really, hasn't got very much in the way of a mark on him. But he's really been taken to the cleaners every single round.
Oh, big punch there.
Wow.
A testament, though, to Rungrat's conditioning, because and also cardio, because he's been on the back foot, he's been literally manhandled to the floor, he's been hit with every trick in the book, and he's still coming back.
It's quite bizarre, in fact, because looking at him in the corner, I mean, he looks tired, but he doesn't really tell the tale of what we've just seen in front of us for the last sort of 9 minutes, you know?
No, that's right. I mean, we're talking about top-level Thais here, you know? They've got so much pride as well, and that's the main thing. They've got so much pride. They never give up attitude. You just see here, look, elbow. That's another left sort of... He tries to palm it out, a left elbow there. The movement there from Greg, trying to switch to southpaw again. That right hand was a cracker, wasn't it?
And the elbow off the back of it as well. Just putting his opponent in all sorts of bother. Again, it's frantic work from the corner of Sasaprapa, just massaging every part of the body, trying to get some blood back into that, trying to wake their man up a little bit.
Corners, 10 seconds. Seconds out.
Well, meanwhile, Greg Wooten knows that really he's just got to carry on doing what he's been doing.
I told you about Greg, not even blowing. Yeah, who can throw that many shots and not be tired?
It's round four.
I said,
four.
I think he's the fittest fighter in the UK.
Stamping that shot into the midsection of Sasaprapa. Again, he comes in with a plan, but within seconds, it's just nullified by the strength and the accuracy of Greg Wooten's shots.
Lovely high kick. It's a tank two. His hands are low. You know, at Rungrat's corner, I've got to seriously think about this, because it's just so one-sided now.
Absolutely. Just the shots coming from legs, from arms. He's been beaten in the clinch. I mean, is there really anything that Sasaprapa can get out of this now? Another 1-2 combination.
His hands are low as well, where he's exhausted.
Still got a round to go after this as well. Surely now only going one way. He said never write anybody off, but it's just been a technical mismatch.
No, it's not even a mismatch. Let's be honest with you, Chris. Rungrat's high level. It just shows, you know, how in form Greg is at the moment. And I tell you, you know, he's UK number one, and I can't see many people beating him in fights like this.
Absolutely not. Oh, and another straight kick to the body, just pushes his man back, the head snap back there. The referee's got to be looking at this.
It looks a matter of time, doesn't it, before he's going to crumble to the floor, but because he's weakened now, he's on the back foot, he's not doing anything back, he's not answering back, really, I think.
Oh, Wooten missed with the first kick, spun. Oh, now the knee comes into the head. And a second.
I personally think the referee's got to have a stop this, or the corner's got to do something, because
Sassy Brabber and bravely walking forwards.
Yeah, but no, there's bravery and there's also corners should be looking into this. Fair play to Greg though. Just took all the wind out of his sails and he's still marching forward.
Look at that, every time he walks forward. Greg just stamping down on the stomach, drilling those kicks into the legs.
Although I may add, Greg's just been cut on the nose. Would you believe it?
Oh, the elbow's coming in. He's out on his feet. The referee's got to come in. Amazingly, Sasha Brabber still fighting. Quite incredible.
Surely now got to seriously think about not putting him out for the fifth round. Got to think about the man's health here, because he was out on his feet.
19 years of age, really. He will live to fight another day, but there's no point really doing any long-term damage to a fighter of that age who's got clearly such a good career ahead of him.
Yeah, it's very, very, very one-sided affair, and I said that. Sasha Prepper's no pushover, but Greg's making him look, honestly, like it's a completely different level in these two. Those push kicks as well, they just take the wind out of you.
Just sending him backwards, completely losing position. It's just the hand speed, the power of the punches as well. Throwing from orthodox and southpaw, and again,
he's unlucky with that.
He really was unlucky, just missed. That spinning kick, and the elbow's driven in as well. Bang, look at that one coming straight in there, and a third. Really, Sasha Prepper has gone well above and beyond what is required, even at this level. And many a fighter would have chucked the towel in.
Yeah, being honest with you, I would have seriously myself, because he's behind. He's not a big banger either, a bung rat.
And, go on, 10 seconds.
You know, I'll be amazed by a miracle if he comes back into it. And
ladies and gentlemen, this is the fifth and the final round.
Well, they have chosen to send him out for this fifth and final round. Whether that's bravery or stupidity, find out in the next 3 minutes. So, Greg Wooten in full charge in the red corner with the orange gloves. Rungrat Sasha Prepper in the blue corner.
He's a killer though, Greg, I tell you. You know, he's clearly ahead, but he still will throw shots to hurt you. He won't just let off and think, well, I'm winning here.
Well, a mistake that cost one or two fighters tonight, and I'm sure that Greg had one eye on
the elbow attempt
on the monitor.
Big hook.
Lands a right hook as well. Sasha Prepper now throwing in those elbows. It's kind of real last ditch stuff from the Thai fighter.
And I said, so proud, you know. Nationally, they're proud. It's their sport. And he's going for those big elbows.
Oh, now Wooten just driving those knees into the midsection, pulling the head down. And then the elbow comes in off the back of it. And again, a second one.
And the tie's now been cut, I believe. And that might just be the blood of Greg.
Walk straight forward onto a southpaw jab. Then the right hand elbow comes in. Another southpaw jab. Low kick from Wooten. Just showing all the tools in the arsenal. So microcosm of the
big
fight.
Big hook, lovely lead right hook. Then the knee.
Huge
into the
knee as well.
Right ribbon. Sassy Crapper has just become a human punch bag, but it's a huge split over the left eye of Greg Wooten.
My God.
Incredible. Now, if you come into this fight midway through the fifth round, you wouldn't have a clue of the story of this fight. Oh, lovely jab.
He's got a nice long lancing jab, hasn't he? You can see now the ties, you know, on the back foot.
Nice low kick and then just catches Satyaprapa as he came forward.
Big head kick punch, lovely.
Fantastic from Wooten and then just digging in that.
I have to say that Rungrat's probably the hardest man I've ever seen.
This is incredible.
Wow.
The number of push kicks he's taken to the chest, to the midsection, and just kept walking forwards. And shouts of finishing for some of the younger members of the audience, but I think Greg Wooten couldn't really have done any more to try.
No, he couldn't have, no.
Another high kick to the head. Satyaprapa hands completely down by his waist now. He's got nothing left, yet he still continues to walk forwards. And even someone with Greg Wooten's engine must question what he could have done to have got his man out of there. Because if he didn't, I can't see anybody that will. As the clock ticks down, an inevitable victory for Greg Wooten. Superb performance, but equally as impressive as Wooten's technical performance was, and Satyaprapa's heart, chin, guts, and desire to stay in the contest. Absolutely riveting stuff from start to finish.
Yeah, you know, Greg just doesn't stop.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's last orders at the bar. Last orders at the bar.
He's been the one that's been beat up. It's incredible.
Makes absolutely no sense at all, does that?
You have 10 minutes.
Well, so Rungrat Satyaprapa can...
Do you want a drink?
So he's won the face test, nothing else.
You can just see there he was going for those desperate elbows, but you know, fair play, he got a cut on Greg. I think that's what caused it there inside, but tenacious, isn't he? Non-stop action. Big elbow. I think he throws another one as well on the gap. There's another one coming up. And you see he just breaks his arm free on the jaw. But Rungrat, my God, the man of steel.
The man of steel indeed, and I'm sure
ladies
he'll be
asked. Ladies and gentlemen,
that.
After five rounds, we go to the scorecards. Your winner by unanimous decision, Greg Wooten. And ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for your runner-up, Rungrat Satyaprapa.
Well, stunning win from Greg Wooten, and he'll take the 200-odd travelling supporters back to London for a party tonight. And a well-deserved victory it is indeed.